गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी सॉल्व सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन द पैरेललोग्राम एंड सम यूजफुल फैक्ट्स अबाउट अ ट्राइंगल. ओके, टुडे वी डिस्कस अ थ्योरम एंड वी सॉल्व सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन दैट थ्योरम. ओके, लेट्स सी द थ्योरम. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थ्योरम. Okay, your theorem is the line segment joining the midpoints of the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle okay is parallel to the third side is parallel to the third side and equal to half of it. Okay, this is your theorem. This is very most important theorem of your NCERT book. Okay, here the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of the triangle is parallel to third side and equal to half of it. Okay, first of all, in proving the theorem, first of all, we draw a triangle ABC. Let us take D and E are the midpoints of the side AB and AC respectively. Okay. And DE is joined. Okay, this is given. We write in given a triangle ABC in which D and E are the midpoints of the sides AB and AC respectively. Okay, AB and AC respectively. Okay, and join AD. D is joined. Okay, then after we write to prove. What I prove? Here your theorem is the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and equal to half of it. We have to show that DE parallel to BC and also DE is equal to half of BC. Okay, we have to show that DE parallel to BC and also DE is equal to half of BC. Okay, here D and E are the midpoints of the triangle. then the line segment joining the midpoints of the triangle is the parallel to third side and half of it. We have to show that this in this proving this theorem we have to do some construction. In construction we produce DE. We produce the line segment DE to F. Produce line segment DE to F in such that DE is equal to EF. Produce to F such that DE is equal to EF. Okay, and join FC. Okay, we have to do some construction in that theorem. Let's see. In construction, what we produce DE to F. Okay, we produce DE to F. Okay, such that DE is equal to EF, and join CFC. And join FC. Okay, we produce DE to F such that DE is equal to EF, and join FC. Okay, now we have to show that. Okay, now next heading is proof. Let us prove. First of all, in triangle A ED and CEF. Okay. First of all, in triangles AED and CEF, and triangle CEF, we have what? Let's see. AE is equal to CE because of E is the midpoint of AC, na? Yes. In that triangle, AE is equal to EC because of E is the midpoint of AC. Write that side, since E is the midpoint of AC. Okay. A is equal to EC. Now let's see. Angle AED is equal to angle CEF. These are the vertically opposite angle. Okay. Also we have angle AED is equal to angle CEF. Angle CEF. This is the vertically opposite angle, and we know that the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, and we have DE is equal to EF by construction. Okay, and we have DE is equal to EF, that is by construction. So by side angle side criterion of congruence, so by side angle side congruence criterion, what we have? Triangle AED congruence to triangle CEF, right? So we have by CBCT what? AD is equal to CF. AD is equal to CF, na? Yes. AD is equal to CF, and angle ADE, that is one relation, and angle ADE is equal to angle CFE. Angle CFE. Let's see. Angle ADE. That angle is equal to angle CFE. दैट एंगल. बोथ वी हैव बाई सी पी सी टी, बाई सी पी सी टी. वाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सी पी सी टी? वाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सी पी सी टी? करस्पॉन्डिंग पार्ट ऑफ कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्रायंगल ना. सो फ्रॉम फिगर वी हैव नाउ डी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी. वी कैन से दैट डी इज द, नाउ फ्रॉम फिगर डी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी ना. ओके, एंड वी हैव ए डी इक्वल टू वॉट? ए डी इक्वल टू डी बी. नाउ फ्रॉम फिगर लेट सी. नाउ फ्रॉम फिगर वॉट? डी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी. इफ डी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी देन वी हैव वॉट? ए डी इज इक्वल टू डी बी. दैट इज वी हैव ए डी इज इक्वल टू डी बी ना. एंड फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन, फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन वी हैव ए डी इक्वल टू सी एफ. सो वी हैव फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन डी बी इक्वल टू सी एफ. वी हैव डी बी इक्वल टू सी एफ. टेक इक्वेशन नंबर थ्री. ओके, लेट सी. डी बी इक्वल टू सी एफ. वी हैव टू प्रूव इट ना. नाउ डी एफ इंटरसेक्ट, डी एफ इंटरसेक्ट ए डी. वी हैव दैट ना. डी बी इक्वल टू सी एफ. ओके, नाउ डी एफ इंटरसेक्ट ए डी एंड एफ सी, एंड एफ सी एट D and F respectively. Okay, such that angle AD is equal to angle CFE. Angle ADE, angle ADE is equal to angle what? CFE. Okay, this is the vertically alternate interior angle ना. alternate interior angle because of DF intersects AD and FC at point D and F respectively ना. and ADE is equal to CFE. so these are the alternate interior angle. Okay, so AD parallel to FC and this implies that DB also parallel to CF and equal. Okay, so we have to show that DBCF is a parallelogram. Okay, here let's see. First of all, we have DB is equal to FC na. Okay, again from equation 1, again from equation 1 we have what? Angle ADE is equal to angle CFE. Let's see. Here from equation angle AD is equal to angle CFE we have, and from figure let's see. Here DF we have to show that DB is equal to CF, and from figure this is parallel to this. Since let's see, AD parallel to CF and ट्रांसवर्सल देन देन ए डी पैरेलल टू सी एफ एंड डी एफ इज अ ट्रांसवर्सल ना, देन हेयर एंगल ए डी ई इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी एफ ई, दीज आर द अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल्स. ओके, सिंस वी हैव वट ए डी पैरेलल टू एफ सी एंड वी हैव टू शो दैट एफ सी ऑल्सो इक्वल टू डी डी बी, सो वी हैव फ्रॉम थ्री वट डी बी पैरेलल टू एफ सी, डी बी पैरेलल टू एफ सी और सी एफ एज वेल एज डी बी इक्वल टू सी एफ. सो दैट इक्वेशन, टेक इक्वेशन नंबर फोर, देन इक्वेशन थ्री एंड फोर वी फाइंड दैट डी बी सी एफ इज अ पैरेलोग्राम क्वाड्रिलेटरल सच दैट वन पेयर ऑफ द साइड्स आर इक्वल एंड पैरेलल. सो द क्वाड्रिलेटरल डी बी सी एफ, सो द क्वाड्री लेटरल डी बी सी एफ सच दैट सच द वन पेयर ऑफ साइड्स आर इक्वल एंड पैरेलल आर इक्वल एंड पैरेलल सिंस डी बी सी एफ इज अ पैरेललोग्राम, सिंस डी बी सी एफ इज अ पैरेललोग्राम. ओके, सिंस वी हैव डी एफ पैरेलल टू बी सी, डी एफ पैरेलल टू बी सी एंड डी एफ इज इक्वल टू बी सी, डी एफ इज इक्वल टू बी सी ना, यस. नाउ लेट सी, यू नो दैट सिंस अपोजिट साइड ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम आर इक्वल एंड पैरेलल, बट वी हैव टू हेयर डी ई एफ बिकॉज ऑफ डी ई एफ आर कोलिनियर ना, डी ई एफ आर कोलिनियर, दे लाइज ऑन द सेम लाइन, बट पॉइंट्स डी ई एंड एफ आर कोलिनियर. ठीक है, ओके, एंड आल्सो डी ई इक्वल टू ई एफ बाय कंस्ट्रक्शन, डी इज इक्वल टू ई एफ सिंस वी हैव डी पैरेलल टू बी सी, बी सी एंड वाट डी इज इक्वल टू ई एफ, सो डी ई इक्वल टू हाफ ऑफ बी सी ना, एंड डी इज इक्वल टू हाफ ऑफ बी सी, हेंस प्रूव्ड. Hence proved that theorem. Okay. So dear students, in this way we prove that type of theorem. Okay. Let's see once more time. Your theorem is the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and equal to half of it. First of all, we draw a triangle ABC, okay, such that D and E are the midpoints of side AB and AC respectively. ए बी एंड ए सी रेस्पेक्टिवली. ओके वी हैव टू शो दैट डी ई इज इक्वल डी ई पैरेलल टू बी सी एंड डी ई इज इक्वल टू हाफ ऑफ बी सी. इन प्रूविंग दैट रिजल्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू डू सम कंस्ट्रक्शन. वी प्रोड्यूस डी ई टू एफ such that DE is equal to EF by construction and join FC. Okay, in proving that result, first of all we have to show that DBCF is a parallelogram. Okay, now first of all we take in triangle AED and CEF, we have to prove that these are congruent to each other. If they are congruent to each other, then we have AD is equal to CF. AD is equal to CF and also triangle ADE is equal to triangle CFE. Okay, now AD is equal to AD is equal to DF and D is the midpoint of AB, so AD is equal to DB, so DB also is equal to CF. And here if this is equal to this and these are the vertically opposite angle na, sorry, alternate interior angle, if these are the alternate interior angles, so line DB also parallel to line CF. So in this way we have to show that DBCF is a quadrilateral in which one pair of sides are equal and parallel. So we can say that the quadrilateral DBCF is a parallelogram. Okay, if DBCF is a parallelogram, then what? Opposite sides are equal and parallel, that is DF is equal to BC and DF parallel to BC. In this figure DEF are collinear because if they lies on the same line, so we have DE parallel to BC and E is the midpoint of DF and DE is equal to half of BC. Okay, so in this way we have to show this theorem. Okay, yes, now we take some other question based on that theorem. Your question is in the given figure DE and F are respectively the midpoints of sides BC, CA and AB of an equilateral triangle ABC. Okay, prove that DEF is also an equilateral triangle. Okay, and your diagram is, let's see on the next page. Let's solve it. From question, ABC is an equilateral triangle and DE and F are the midpoints of the side BD, BC, AC and AB respectively. Okay, prove that DEF, we join this point, DEF is also an equilateral triangle. Okay, from figure let's see From figure we know that the line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of the triangle is half of the third sides. Okay. Now from figure D is equal to half of AB. From figure, according to previous theorem, the midpoints of line joining the midpoints the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of the triangle is half of the third side. That is DE is equal to what? Half of AB. Similarly, EF is equal to half of BC, and FD is equal to half of AC. Take equation 1. Now, ABC is an equilateral triangle, na? Now, triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. That is, you know that in any equilateral triangle all sides are equal to each other. That is AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. This implies that we multiply 1 by 2 both on whole the equation over 1 by 2 of AB, 1 by 2 of BC is equal to 1 by 2 of CA. Okay. Now we have using equation 1. We have in from equation 1 we have half of AB we write DE, half of BC we write EF, half of AC we write FD. Okay, so here we write half of AB as DE, half of BC write EF, and half of CA or AC write FD. Now let's see from the triangle of triangle DEF, all sides DE is equal to EF is equal to FD. So we can say that we can say that DEF triangle DEF is an equilateral triangle. Okay, proof. Okay, let's see once more time. ABC is a triangle is to be given, and DEF are the midpoints of the side BC, CA, and AB respectively. We have to show that triangle DEF is also an equilateral triangle. In proving that result, first of all, we know that the line segment joining to any midpoints of two sides of the triangle is equal to half of the third side. So in using this theorem, we have DE is equal to half of AB, F is equal to half of BC, FD is equal to half of AC. Since ABC is a equilateral triangle, so in this way we get this result. In this way we can say that DEF is an equilateral triangle. Okay, so dear students, first of all you solve all the questions of your NCERT exercise based on that theorem. Okay, thank you.